Jasmine, thanks for taking the time out and speaking to BW Business World here at the Festival of FinTech. I just wanted to get an impression on how do you see FinTech kind of working out in India in 2024? How do you see it has evolved in the past few years?
I think the biggest change that we are seeing in the FinTech industry over the last few years is that it has moved from a growth focused to a profit focused industry, wherein earlier we've seen that fintechs used to chase growth over and above profits. But I think now with the fintech window coming in and still continuing for some time, I think people have understood that profitability and having the right business model is very, very important to be a sustainable fintech player in the industry. As far as opportunities are concerned, I think there are still a lot of gaps in the financial sector that fintechs can address across various segments. So whether it is an MSME segment or whether it is a women specific segment or whether it is a B2B segment, I think we see a lot of opportunities where fintechs can play out. Now, whether it is InsurTech or whether it is Wealth Tech or whether it is Lending Tech or whether it is Payments Tech, I think the opportunities are immense. Even global collaborations, expanding business in Southeast Asia or expanding business to the Middle East are also some of the avenues opening up for Indian fintechs now. So I think this is the golden time for Indian fintechs, and 2024 and 25 should be booming time. And the best thing that we are looking at is the collaboration that's happening within the industry between fintechs, banks, NBFCs, MFIs, and all the players are actually the boundaries and the names that we give specifically, whether this is an NBFC or whether this is a bank. I think the boundaries are getting blurred. Now everybody is a financial industry player and everybody is competing against everybody through collaborations.
Jasmine, one of the things that comes to mind is, are there any gaps in the landscape that perhaps can be filled by a lot more ideas, lot more startups? Of course, the landscape is going to grow moving forward. What are your perspectives on that?
I think a lot of opportunities exist on the RegTech side, on the DeepTech side. Also, within the space of lending tech, for example, there are some deeper opportunities in terms of enabling customers to improve their credit scores or enabling customers to, you know, alternate database underwriting models. While we have some models in the industry, I think a lot of more work needs to be done also in the space of financial inclusion. While we talk about digital, while we talk about fintech initiatives, the grassroots level, I think, while every household has a smartphone, there's a lot that needs to be done to ensure that they are not just digital literate, but they are also financial and digital literate, so that they are able to capitalize on the opportunities and the solutions that we are building for the grassroots level as well. So I think in terms of opportunities, gaps, a lot exists in terms of various segments. And there's so much scope for more new entrants to get into the space. And we are looking at, you know, bankers, NBFC players, MFI players, also to get into the digital space and share their age-old experience. Because I think the new age digital experience with the traditional business know-how is a win-win at the end of the day.
Thank you. Thank you for taking the time out and speaking to BW.
Thank you so much.